It appears that Canada has a yet-to-be-discovered volcano, and this could pose a major hazard in the future if it was to ever erupt again. As, during the month of October in 1898, numerous gold prospectors were working at several placer mines in the Atlin area when they noticed something strange. In the very far distance, almost at the edge of the horizon, a plume of white smoke was rising from the ground. This was somewhat unusual, as no large-scale wildfires were known to be ongoing in the vicinity, and to make things even weirder, this smoke stayed in the same location for several weeks. Then, during the night on November 8th, a bright orange glow lit up the sky, allowing for miners to work with a level of light similar to twilight during a period when there was only 6.5 hours of sunlight each day. Then, what appeared to be a tall lava fountain was generated, reaching more than 1,000 feet into the sky near the horizon, which lit up the ground just enough to be able to walk around at night in a 40-mile radius. A volcanic eruption was ongoing and would continue for several weeks, causing ash to intermittently fall on several gold placer mines in the vicinity of the town of Atlin, interrupting work. By the time this eruption ended on December 3rd, up to 2 inches thick of ash had fallen on one of the placer mines, meaning the volcanic eruption which had just occurred probably had a volcanic explosivity index of a low end 3. Since there is an active volcanic field right next to the town of Atlin, you might think that that was the culprit of this event. As, in the so-called Atlin volcanic field, 2 cinder cone-forming eruptions are known to have postdated the end of the last ice age. Yet, both of these vents are too heavily eroded to have only formed 125 years ago, with their lava flows being too heavily vegetated. For comparison, here is a lava flow which erupted from Canada's Iskut-Yunuk River cones in 1904, with only grasses and no trees existing on its mass. However, the true nail in the coffin which proved that the Atlin volcanic field did not generate this eruption was that only a fraction of the gold miners actually saw it. Only those who were working in the westernmost of the Atlin gold fields with a fairly unobstructed view to the south-southwest saw the eruption occur, with lava being seen from the McKee, Pine, and Birch Creeks, but not the Ruby, Boulder, Otter, and Spruce Creeks. Supposedly, some prospectors making their way from Skagway to Atlin on parts of the famous Klondike Trail even saw this eruption occur, with later newspapers claiming the volcano was 50 miles south of Gladys Lake. However, there are absolutely no young lava flows at that location. Since I personally followed much of the Klondike Gold Rush Trail during the summer, I was able to observe which mountains blocked the line of sight and which were visible. As a result, in my opinion, if a volcanic eruption did occur, the only area which could have been seen from 4 distinct points, but not 4 others, was a 1,750 square kilometer strip of land that is almost completely covered by glaciers. Miners at the time reported that this eruption occurred at a height of 14,000 feet, but no peaks in the area are that height. Thus, I am assuming that the height of peaks were greatly overestimated due to the lack of quantifiable features such as trees to base a size estimate off of, suggesting it occurred at a largely ice-covered mountain. Further details suggest the Strombolian eruption occurred at a mountain with 4 closely spaced peaks, with the eruption occurring just below the summit of the second northernmost peak, with this peak being smaller than the other 3 neighboring peaks. I have not been able to find any peaks which fit this description, but here is why my audience can help. If by chance you live in Skagway, Atlin, or any other location within 100 miles of Atlin, there is a chance that you might have seen an ash layer within the top 3 inches of soil where you live and never thought much of it, but I must stress the ash did not have a white color. If you find something which fits this description, please send me the relevant GPS coordinates by email where the ash was found with a photo of the layer. That way, we can together finally identify this missing volcano. As a final note, I want to say that I have ruled out several other theories which are listed below. However, there are also 2 additional theories which are also each somewhat plausible. I would like to thank my new patron, Shannon Smith, for supporting this channel.